In this video, I will share with you Daniel Schmachtenberger's top 10 tips for health. Number 10 are VLI lasers. You can buy these lasers on the internet and you attach them to your head and your nose. They can get quite expensive, but it is a powerful biohack if you want to boost your cognition. In fact, it is so powerful that you don't want to use these lasers daily. Number 9 is Qualia. Daniel has invented a supplement that combines 42 ingredients that act synergistically and they really boost your brain function. Not only in the short term, but also in the long run. So they are helping your brain be and stay healthy and function optimally. I personally have not tried Qualia yet, but I am definitely going to buy it in the future. It can be quite expensive, but if you were to buy all of these 42 ingredients alone, it would be even more expensive. And Daniel really has put a lot of effort into discovering what the best supplemental stack is. And from the reports I've read, it is clear that Qualia is one of the, if not the best nootropic on the planet. So I am definitely going to buy Qualia in the future. And if you are thinking about buying Qualia, please look into my description. I have asked the company that makes it if I can become their affiliate because I want to make money. And if they allow me to, I will add a coupon code into the description that will make the Qualia cheaper for you. If not, I don't care much because I would recommend Qualia anyway. Qualia Mind seems especially powerful, but even the other ones like Mind and Immune and Life are awesome. Number 8 is to be aware of short-term smart drugs. So we are talking about modafinil or Adderall, or about many of these mostly synthetic supplements. They do boost your brain function, but only in a short term. And in the long run, they actually decrease it. And sometimes they even create dependence and addictions. Not all synthetic drugs or nootropics are bad, but be really careful because some of them will cause irreversible damage to your brain. Number 7 is a vegan diet. Now, Daniel is not necessarily a vegan for health reasons, but he does recommend a vegan diet because he finds it more sustainable for the planet and for them animals than eating animals. He obviously is against factory farming, which should be banned without a single doubt. But then he also would not eat grass-finished meat either. Because even though these animals might be living a happy life, you also would not like to get slaughtered. And so why would we do that to other living beings? There's a counter argument to that, which is that in nature, this is how things work. But now that we have the ability to go for plants instead of animals and be healthy, why would we eat animals and harm them? Some people do have a hard time being vegans because they run into all sorts of deficiencies, be it a zinc deficiency or iron or B12 deficiency, but this doesn't have to happen. In the vast majority of cases, it is completely preventable. And I'm a vegan myself and I feel better than I ever did. Number 6 is microdosing with psychedelics. Microdosing is incredibly powerful for treating depression and boosting your cognition and all that stuff. So Daniel is a fan and he also believes that psychedelics should be legalized, at least for psychotherapy purposes, which I could not agree more with. And it makes me angry that people who are depressed or have PTSD don't have this option, because psychedelics truly are powerful tools. And every single person who is denying that is doing so because of social conditioning. And I'm not judging these people because I used to be the same. But Daniel recommends that you want to combine microdosing or high doses of psychedelics with either neurofeedback or meditation and with some supplements. Specifically, cholinergics and Siltep is what I've heard him mentioning. Number 5 is to do mentally difficult tasks to improve your brain. Be it coding or starting a blog or a business or learning to dance. All of these things that challenge your brain are awesome for you. They help you boost both your neurogenesis and your neuroplasticity. Neurogenesis means that more neurons can be created in your brain, and neuroplasticity is that you create connections between those neurons, which is a great benefit that you will get from learning new skills. Number 4 is to focus on your sleep first, because the way you sleep is way more important for your health than being a vegan or taking Qualia or moving around. These things are extremely important, but if your sleep quality is poor or you are not sleeping enough, you will not be healthy and you will not feel good. So get enough sleep and sleep well. Number three is that if you don't want to buy Qualia and you want to create a nootropic stack yourself, be really careful, because all of these nootropics have their distinct effects and some combination could actually harm you, even if the nootropics are natural. That is why I would not recommend creating your own nootropic stack until you have a ton of knowledge. I myself do feel like I am reasonably knowledgeable in this field, and yet I would never try to create my nootropic stack because there is just so much that can go wrong. So for me, I will not go heavy on nootropics before I get to buy Qualia. And I will for now only stick to herbs like ashwagandha and turmeric and some extracts like L-theanine. Number two is to try to think independently. So don't take my word for anything or Daniel's word. Daniel Schmachtenberger is an incredibly smart guy, and what he says almost always makes a lot of sense. He has an in-depth knowledge on so many subjects, but even then, he says that you should not take what he says for granted. So if you can and if you have time for that, try to verify things. And if you cannot, at least learn from reliable sources. So in the health community, for example, it would be Daniel, but also Peter Attia and Rhonda Patrick and David Sinclair, guys like that, and not some TV doctors. Like if you study nutrition from Dr. Burke or Thomas DeLauer or the TV show The Doctors, you will not be healthy, or at least you will not feel your best. Number one is to look at health systematically, because our body is a super complex system and everything inside of it impacts everything else. So even if something is good for your brain, it may not be worth it because it can be bad for your gut or damage your liver. So think systematically and try to find foods and movement patterns and habits that improve your body in general. I love you so much. Thank you for watching, and please share this video if you find it helpful.